Well off the busy main roads and nestled into gently rising hills is the lovely little village of Ilam in East Staffordshire. In the centre of the village is the Gothic cross, erected in memory of Mary Watts Russell in 1840. Ilam is touched by the river manifold which meanders around the hall and under this graceful bridge. The original village was repositioned and rebuilt in the 19th century by the owner of the hall. He chose to term his design Alpine style. We started our walk from the cross and ambled over the bridge to get down to the river. Here, along the banks of the manifold, we could drink in the sights and sounds of April in rural England. The slightly cold, misty weather did not distract from the enjoyment of the day. Thank you. The next bridge over the river is our turning point. Here, our stroll takes us back to Ilam on the other side of the River Manifold. Whenever you walk in these peatland hills, your constant companions are the many sheep. Now it's time we leave the river and tackle high ground, where there's more dry stone walls and more sheep. That reminds me, must look for a tea shop soon. It's not long before we descend once more into the village. Tucked away and not easily seen from the road is Ilam Hall. Ilam Hall's long history was erased in the 19th century by Watts Russell, who demolished the building and replaced it with a new one. This, in turn, was in a large part demolished in 1934 when it was given to the National Trust and became a youth hostel. The shop was open while we were there, but sadly, not the tea rooms. So our tails were dragging, but not wagging. The terrace overlooks the church, which is of Norman origin. Our walk comes to an end as we return to the village. Here we can contemplate more mundane pleasures and ponder on an afternoon well spent.